So good morning everyone. So today we are here to discuss about generators of SU2 and SU3 group. So in the class, last class we have discussed about special orthogonal and special unitary group cases, and also in, at the end of the session we were discussed about the case of finding the generator of a SO2 and SO3 group, that is we have discussed in the last class. And today we will be discussing about So we'll have generators of SU2 and SU3, that is special unitary matrix of order 2 and special unitary matrix of order 3. Okay, so we'll discuss that here, and we'll know that when you consider an SU2 matrix, so we'll have the representation corresponding to that. So when you have SU2, we are given an example. Okay, so the corresponding matrix we have represented as SU2, we have represented as e raised to I alpha plus beta, okay, cos eta. Okay, then e raised to I alpha minus beta sine eta minus e raised to minus alpha minus beta sine eta, then e raised to minus alpha plus beta cos eta. Okay, so this is the representation we'll have here. And let me just put x is equal to alpha plus beta. Okay, so let me just put, in order to find the generators of special unitary matrix, so let me just put alpha plus beta is equal to x. Okay, then alpha minus beta is equal to y. Okay, and eta equal to, let me put it as z. Okay, these are the angles we'll have here, and if I do that, the above SU2 matrix will transform into, okay, this can be transformed into e raised to I x cos z and e raised to I y sine z, okay, minus e raised to minus I y, okay, sine z, then e raised to minus ix cos z. So we'll have the representation we'll have in like in this fashion. Okay, so that is when I want to find the generator corresponding to sx, that is sx is equal to minus I, okay, minus I dr by dx. So like we have a representation, and similarly here we can take SU of matrix. So let me just take the d by dx of the above matrix. Okay, at let me just take x is equal to y 0 and z is equal to 0 here. So this is our SU2. Okay, and that is equal to minus I. When you differentiate, you will be having cos z into e raised to I x, okay, into I will be there, okay, and 0 here, minus e raised to I x, here minus I will be there, okay, minus I e raised to I cos z will be there. Okay, Now I put x is equal to 0 and y z is equal to 0. Okay, so in that condition I'll be getting, so I'll be obtaining minus I into I 0 0 minus I, so that is equal to 1 0 0 minus 1. When you multiply minus I into the inside the matrix, you will have 1 0 0 minus 1. So this is equal to sigma 3. Okay, this is a Pauli matrix of order 3. Okay, now let me just do the same by taking in the case of SZ. Okay, where minus I okay, so let me just, the unitary matrix, let me just put it as U. Okay, so U by dz, let me just say that. Okay, that is as y is equal to 0 and z is equal to 0, let me evaluate. Okay, so that I'll be getting minus I into minus ix sine z, because we are taking with respect to z here, and e raised to iy cos z, and minus ey cos z minus x sin z at y is equal to 0 and z is equal to 0. You need to evaluate. Then you do that, what you will be getting, minus I into 0 1 minus 1 0 you will be obtaining. So that is, this is equal to what, this will be equal to, when you multiply minus I into the inside, you will have 0 minus I 0. This is, you are familiar with the earlier discussion, this is our sigma 2, it is a Pauli matrix of sigma 2 order. Okay, and now let me just do this same in with respect to y as well. So that is sy is equal to minus I du by dy, where u is the unitary matrix that is we are evaluating. So here we have to evaluate y equal to z and z is equal to 0. Sorry, z is equal to 90 in this case. Okay, z is equal to 90 degree. And when you do that, you will be having, the representation will be minus I into, and this part will be 0, I e raised to iy sine z. Okay, I into e raised to minus iy sine z. Okay, 0 will be coming. Okay, so that is equal to, when you do that, you will be having this is y is equal to 0 and z is equal to 90 degree situation, that is an angle corresponding to that, and minus I will have 0. Here we will be having, or I is there, and here is to minus I will also corresponding to that, and we will have minus I here, and here you will be having again I, and this is 0. So that is minus I, if you multiply, you will remaining 0 1 1 0. So that is equal to sigma 1. Okay, so this is the representation we will be obtaining corresponding to the generator matrix of this one. So what we basically saying is that we are basically understanding the generator matrix of SU of 2 only, because SU of 3, if you take, that will be a bit complicated. So we are not going into that anyway. Okay, so anyway, the generator matrix corresponding to SU of 2, what we are obtaining is that is sigma 1, sigma 2 and sigma 3, where sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 3 are the Pauli matrices. There are three Pauli matrices we know. Okay, that is sigma 1 equal to, as you can see, that is 0, 1, 1, 0, and that is sigma 2 will have the representation 0 minus I 0, and sigma 3 as we obtained, so that is 1 0 0 minus 1. Okay, so that's about the generator of the matrix. So these are the generator of a unitary matrix as we understood here. Okay, now let me go to a next topic, that is we will be discussing about the homomorphism case of. Okay, so when you take the homomorphism case of SO of 3 and SU of 2 homomorphism. Okay, so in this case we know that homomorphism is a many to one mapping basically. Okay, so we'll consider here, we'll consider a 2 by 2 matrix. Okay, can be defined as a, can be defined as a linear combination of combination of poly matrix, all poly matrices. That is, let I can write as, that is M is equal to X sigma 1 plus Y sigma 2 plus Z sigma 3. Okay, so that is M is equal to, we'll have M is equal to X into, we know sigma 1 is 0 1 1 0. Okay, plus Y into sigma 2 is 0 minus I 0, okay, plus Z 1 0 0 minus 1, that is sigma 3. Okay, now if you do this expansion, what you'll be getting is that 0 X, okay, and X 0 plus 0 minus I y 0, okay, plus we'll have Z 0 0 minus Z, so that will be getting here. Now in this situation, so we'll go to Z X minus IY, okay, X plus IY and minus Z will be obtaining finally if you do the matrix addition. Okay, so here if you consider another matrix, so now we got M is equal to this matrix, it is a combination of different other matrices. Okay, now let me just take M dash is another matrix, okay, which is another matrix, okay, under unitary operation, okay, under unitary operation, or under, we can say that under unitary operation or under similarity transformation. Okay, similarity transformation. So this similarity transformation we have done when we have said about reducible and irreducible, reducible and irreducible representations case. Okay, now here let me just add that M dash is equal to U dash plus UM U dagger, where we use the unitary matrix. Okay, so we are taking the unitary matrix corresponding to this, and we are taking the U dagger of that one. Okay, so that M dash will be equal to, so the transformed M dash will be Z dash X dash minus I Y dash, then X dash plus I Y dash, okay, minus Z dash. So this is our M dash representation that you'll be obtaining for this case. Okay, now if you if I would say the representation corresponding to this, that M dash, you can just simply say that it is like X dash into sigma 1 plus Y dash into sigma 2 plus Z dash into sigma 3 will be resulting to the above matrix. Now if you determinant of this matrix M okay, if you do the determinant of this case, okay, determinant of matrix M and M dash, then you will find that when you find that in that case, you will be obtaining the, for example, the determinant of M, okay, dash will be equal to determinant of M. Okay, so So it is actually a property that is actually defined by a unitary similarity transformation. It is one of the property, okay, it is one of the property of unitary similarity transformation. Okay, so that you can write determinant of M equal to determinant of M dash. Okay, now if you do that, so we can say that Z dash square plus Y dash square plus X dash square, so there will be a minus, so that is equal to minus Z square plus Y square plus Z square, sorry, this is X square. Okay, so now we consider, let me just consider the unitary matrix as, okay, so I'll be considering here, consider a unitary matrix. Okay, so when we consider a unitary matrix U, we said that there is a general representation, that is A, B and minus B star, A star, that means A star and B star is the complex conjugate of A and B. Okay, so this is a representation of a unitary matrix we used to do, and this is a special unitary as well. When you do the determinant, you will be getting the determinant will be equal to 1 as well, so that's why it's a special unitary matrix. Okay, so let me just put in this case, let me just put A equal to, okay, let me just put A equal to e raised to I phi. Raised to I phi, and let me just put B equal to 0. Okay, so that is the case because such kind of representation we have done earlier as well. Okay, now if you take U equal to will be equal to what, then e raised to I phi 0, 0 e raised to minus I phi will come. Okay, okay, fine. And now if I do the unitary transformation on the case of, for example, let me just do the unitary transformation under U x sigma 1 U dagger. Okay, so that is equal to, you will be getting e raised to I phi 0, 0 e raised to minus I phi, okay, into x, so into sigma 1, that is a polymatrix I said, that is 0, 1, 1, 0, okay, then again you need to multiply e raised to minus I phi, that is you have to do the complex conjugate, U dagger means it is complex conjugate matrix, right, so e raised to minus I phi 0 and 0 e raised to I phi will come. Okay, this is how the representation will look like. And now if you do this representation, you can actually, you will be having the corresponding representation. I can simplify as e raised to I phi 0, 0 e raised to minus I phi. Okay, and now if you do multiply, that is this I can write as x, sorry, this will be 0, 0 x, x 0, okay, into e raised to minus I phi 0, 0 e raised to I phi. Okay, so that is about U dagger representation. Now, if you further proceed with this form, so this will be further equal to e raised to I phi, okay, I phi 0, 0 e raised to minus I phi. Okay, first I'll do the multiplication over there, and I'll be getting here zero x e raised to I phi okay, then x e raised to minus I phi okay, then 0, and now further if you evaluate, you gonna get is that x is equal to 0 x raised to e raised to 2i5 and x raised to e raised to minus 2i5 0. So this is how you will be gonna get. And now we know this representation, I can also transform like this. That is, we know that e raised to i 2i5 I can write in terms of what? In terms of cos i5. So first element is 0 and this will be x into cos 2 phi plus I sin 2 phi. Okay, and here we'll have again x into cos 2 phi minus, because e raised to minus 2 i5, so that is my minus I sin 2 phi. Okay, and the last term will be 0. So this is how the matrix will look like now. And now further, if you proceed with that, the unitary similarity operation will look like, that is equal to, so this I can take like this, that is, let me take x outside. Okay, this I can write like this, x into 0 cos 2 phi and cos 2 phi 0 plus ix, okay, ix 0 sin 2 phi minus sin 2 phi 0. Okay, so that is, this I can further, if you take x cos 2 phi also, you take it outside, then in that case you'll have 0 1 1 0 notation will be there. And on the other side also you can do the similar fashion, that is minus sine 2 phi if you take outside. Okay, and you can take this I, you can multiply to inside. Okay, this I you can take into inside, and sine 2 phi you can minus sine 2 phi you can take it outside. That is x sin 2 phi, okay, sorry, so we'll have minus x sin 2 phi. So here we take minus sin 2 phi outside and we'll be multiplying I to inside, that is 0, okay, 0 minus I 0, okay. So what we have done is that minus 2 sin 2 phi we take it outside, then I we multiply to inside the matrix. So what we'll be getting here is that, so we can say that this matrix will be further can be said as, this is equal to x, what is 0 1 1 0 mean, it is sigma 1 cos 2 phi minus, and x this is 0 minus I 0, that is sigma 2 cos, sorry, sine sigma 2 sine 2 phi. Okay, so this is how you will be getting the corresponding representation of u x sigma 1 u dagger means. Okay, and similarly if you do this one for the case of u y sigma 2 u dagger. Okay, so in that fashion, so it is a raised to I5 0 0 e raised to minus I5 la. So in the same way, y into sigma 2 we know 0 I, sorry, 0 minus I 0 la. So into e raised to I5, sorry, minus e raised to I 0 0 e raised to I5. Okay, and now on the similar fashion you can proceed like earlier case we have done. Okay, so when you do that, e raised to I5 0 0 e raised to minus I5, okay, and we'll have 0 iy minus iy and iy 0, okay, and into e raised to minus i5 0 0 e raised to i5, okay. So further if you proceed, you will be having e raised to i5 0 0 e raised to minus i5, okay. So this is what we will be getting when you do the similarity transformation, that is minus iy e raised to i5 iy into e raised to minus i5 0, okay. So this is again, if you proceed, you will be getting 0 minus iy e raised to 2i5, okay, then iy e raised to minus 2i5 0, okay. Now again, you can actually expand e raised to 2i5, you can expand like 0 minus iy into cos 2i plus I sin 2i, okay, and here we will have iy into cos 2 phi minus I sin 2 phi, okay, then we will have 0 element here, okay. And on the same fashion that is we have in the above case, you can actually take the representation, you can extract y cos 2 phi, you can take it outside, and into 0 minus I 0 will come, okay, plus iy, okay, plus if also will have plus if you do the y iy will be, you will have inside 0 minus I 0, okay, sin 2 phi, and this minus I also you take it inside. So you'll have actually the representation will be here also, it is minus I think, okay. So this also will minus, and what you'll be getting here is that finally you'll be getting y cos 2 phi sigma 2 plus you will have 10110 sin 2 phi. This is how you have to get, okay, and that means I can say that similarity operation u on y sigma 2 u dagger, that is equal to y sigma 2 cos 2 phi, okay, plus y sigma 1 sin 2 phi, so, okay. So this is how you will be getting, and similarly you can also try out for operation on like this. Simply you can also try for u on z sigma 3 u dagger, okay, same one you can also try out. So in that case you will be like e raised to i5 0 e raised to minus i5 0, okay. So this you can do by yourself, so I am not doing again. So it is into z into here will be having 10 0 1 la, that is sigma 3 then namak undirna representation sigma 3 will be just it is. Okay, 0 minus 1 la minus 1, okay, so this you can do by yourself. When you do that, you'll be what you'll be getting finally will be, so into e raised to i5 minus i5 la 0 e raised to i5, okay, and when you do this you will be having z into e raised to i5 0 0 minus z into e raised to i5, okay. Zero e raised to i5, okay, anyway, in any fashion you can do, and whenever you do that, you will be having correspondingly here. Okay, in this case, will be representation will be, you will be having. Let me just write it. So you finally gonna get z equal to z 0 minus z. You will be getting here. Okay, and finally you will be equal to, if you take z outside, you will have 1 0 minus 1. That is equal to z sigma 3. Okay, so that is we'll be getting here for this representation. Okay, now let me come back to our matrix case where you will be having, we have m dash is equal to what? M dash is equal to u m u dagger. Okay, so it is a similarity, after similarity transformation on m you will get m dash. So that means, so here you can actually give u equal to, what is m? M we notated in x sigma 1, y sigma 2 plus z sigma 3. Okay, so now you know what is u x sigma 1 u dagger is. Okay, then you know what is u sigma 2 u y sigma 2 u dagger is, and u z sigma 3 u dagger is. That is already we have obtained in our different discussions. So that is above, this is already we identified, that is x sigma 1 cos 2 phi minus x sigma 2 sin 2 phi plus y sigma 2, use y sigma 2 u dagger, that is y sigma 2 cos 2 phi plus y sigma 1 sin 2 phi, okay, plus u z sigma 3 u plus u dagger, that is we identified as sigma, sorry, z sigma 3. Okay, so this is how you will be getting for that case. Now I can say that in the above representation, so if I write all the terms corresponding to sigma 1 together, so sigma 1 into, I will be getting x cos 2 phi plus y sin 2 phi will be there, okay, plus sigma 2 into minus x sin 2 phi plus y cos 2 phi will be there. So I just corrected all the terms corresponding to sigma 1, sigma 2 and sigma 3, and plus we'll have z sigma 3. Okay, now let me just represent this entire representation is, okay, let me just make it a different way. So this notation is actually x dash, and this notation will be our y dash. And this you can take it as, this entire term you can take it as z dash. Okay, so that is z is, there is no change corresponding to that. Okay, so that means when I write the equation, x dash is equal to, x dash is equal to, I can say as x cos 2 phi plus y sin 2 phi, and y dash is equal to minus x sin 2 phi, okay, plus y cos 2 phi, and our z dash is equal to what? It is z itself. Okay, now if you give that into the representation, in the above representation, so we'll get m dash is equal to, m dash is equal to x dash sigma 1 plus y dash sigma 2 plus z dash sigma 3. So this is what we need to get it after all. Okay, now if I just represent in the matrix wherever we have 2 phi, okay, wherever we have 2 phi, so in matrix form, in order to represent, so when it comes to matrix, so I am just put 2 phi equal to alpha. Okay, so that is x dash, y dash and z dash is equal to, I can just like write like this, this is cos alpha sin alpha minus sin alpha cos alpha 0 0 0 0 1. So you can this actually this transformation matrix of x transforming to x dash I can write like this. Okay, so where phi 2 phi equal to alpha, or rather I can say that phi equal to what, phi equal to alpha by 2 notation. Okay, now what we finally we need to get it that, so we need to represent a 2 by 2 matrix corresponding to that. That is a 2 by 2 unitary transformation matrix. Transformation matrix. So here you can represent U of alpha by 2. That is U phi. Okay, that is equal to e raised to I alpha by 2. 0 0 e raised to minus minus alpha by 2. Okay, this one more, there is more correction. Okay, here it is minus I alpha by 2. So this is how we will be representing as a 2 by 3 matrix, and is equivalent to, and which is equivalent to what, equivalent to, which is equivalent to the rotational or orthogonal matrix that is we already has been discussed. Okay, and now if you just compare this above representation, like we know that whereas r of alpha 0 0, hope you remember that. So that is what it is, cos alpha sin alpha 0 minus sin alpha cos alpha 0 and 0 0 1. So it is our rotational matrix that is we represented earlier. Okay, now if I do represent this representation, that is U of alpha by 2. Okay, so that is e raised to I alpha by 2 0 and 0 e raised to minus I alpha by 2. Okay, so this is how it will come. So now when you come just take the homomorphism between R alpha 0 0 and U alpha by 2. So this is actually a 3 by 3 matrix. Okay, the order is 3 here. Okay, and in when you consider here, this is a 2 by 2 matrix. Okay, so when you take the R of alpha with respect to U of alpha. Okay, so we'll have a 1 to 1 correspondence you cannot find here. So we'll have many to 1 correspondence, you can find it over here. Okay, so okay, so we'll also have a 1 to 1 correspondence corresponding to this symbol matrix that you will be obtaining here. Okay, so let me just take an example so that you will be understanding better here. Okay, so we'll be getting a corresponding 2 by 2 and R by R2 matrix. So we can actually share the homomorphism between SU of 2 and SU of 2 matrix here by taking the correspondence of representation here. Okay, so to check by taking an example here, so we'll do one question here. So to check two to one correspondence from alpha to alpha plus 2 phi, where alpha is range from 0 to 2 pi, then in this case we need to actually consider u alpha by 2 plus pi. Okay, so that is equal to u of alpha by 2. So that is, when you consider that e raised to I alpha by 2 plus pi, okay, 0 e raised to minus alpha by 2 plus pi notation will be there. Okay, so this is our matrix we'll be having here. Okay, now let me just expand this representation, because this is equivalent to what? This is equivalent to the corresponding matrix like cos alpha plus 2 pi, okay, and sin alpha plus 2 phi and minus sin alpha plus 2 pi and cos alpha plus 2 phi 0 0 0 1. Okay, so we can represent the above representation in this fashion, that is, this is equation corresponding to what? So this is equal to r of alpha plus 2 pi. Okay, now if you check the correspondence here, you will actually taking, for example, u of alpha by 2, if you represent. So in that case, we'll have e raised to e raised to alpha plus pi, means that is minus I alpha by 2, okay, 0, and 0 minus e raised to minus I alpha by 2, because that you are taking alpha by 2 plus pi. Okay, so and here when you do that, when you have a correspondence with respect to cos alpha plus 2 phi, you can say that cos alpha sin alpha 0, then here we'll have minus sin alpha cos alpha 0 0 0 1. Okay, so here we have two matrices. Now if you just compare here, we'll actually, this is representing our SU of alpha by 2, and this is our R of alpha matrix. And you can see that here the order is 2 and here the order is 3. So we'll have the correspondence will be a 2 to 1 correspondence, corresponding to 2 element. So we'll have 1 element here. Okay, so that is, when you consider, so the correspondence we'll able to see is that it is a 2 to 1 correspondence. You can see here, like earlier cases also we have seen the many to 1 correspondence between R of alpha and U of alpha, and similar representation we'll be seeing here as well. Okay, and now if you do the rotation, for example, sin alpha by 2, sin alpha plus 2 phi, okay, is cos alpha plus 2 phi. Okay, so this I can say that is approximately equal to alpha. Okay, approximately you can say that value is alpha. So in that situation, I could say that in any case, if you represent u of alpha by 2 and u of minus alpha by 2, okay, will both correspond to what? Correspond to the R of alpha and it is showing, and this correspondence is like what? This correspondent is, it is 2 to 1 correspondence, right? 2 to 1 correspondence means what? It is actually like a many to one correspondent. Many to let me just write it. Okay, many to one correspondence. Many to one correspondence. So when you have a many to correspondence, this is, we know that this is a unitary matrix. Okay, unitary matrix, and this is our orthogonal matrix. Okay, orthogonal matrix of order SU of 3. Right. Now from this we can actually say that these are also SU of 2, order of 2, right? Special unitary matrix of order 2. So what we will be getting is that we can say that since U of alpha by 2 and R of alpha showing homomorphism, so then we can say that we started with the case that is SU of 2 and SO of 3 are homomorphic to each other from the above discussion. Okay, because U of alpha by 2 is a SU of 2 matrix, R of alpha is SO of 3 matrix, that is special orthogonal matrix of order 3 and special unitary matrix of order 2 case. Okay, so these are the discussion of about group theory. Okay, I think almost the module of group theory discussion is done with here, and if anything remains on the session, that we will be discussing on the next class, and we'll do a few more problems also in the next class. Okay, so with that we have almost winded up the session. So if anything remains, that we'll be discussing on the next class. Otherwise, this is an end to the second module of mathematical physics. Okay.